Hey everybody, my name is Michael. I post weekly videos about swimming, biking, and running. If you're watching last week, you would have seen that last week was a recovery week for me. Well, this week we are jumping right back into it with an indoor triathlon at my local gym, FFC, here in Chicago. I'm going to tell you all about it, but first, check out these videos.
Thank you.
Put two on.
How do you feel?
I'm hot. I'm worn out. Okay.
Crushed it. Yeah. More than a 5K.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you, FFC, for hosting a great indoor triathlon earlier today at the gym. I really appreciate all the work and the volunteers that put their time to make the event such a success. Thank you, everybody. Before we go any further, make sure you're subscribed below though, so that make sure that you don't miss out on any of the other swim, bike, or run related content to come. I still have a lot of goals left in 2020 to accomplish, including 70.3 Des Moines and the Chicago Marathon. So make sure you're subscribed so that you don't miss out on any of that exciting content. Back to the indoor triathlon. Now, if you don't know what an indoor triathlon is, well, it is exactly what you just saw. You start with 10 minutes in the pool, followed by a transition, 30 minutes on the indoor bike, and then 20 minutes on the treadmill. Your distances from each event are added together, and then you are given a score at the end. I think these are perfect events for beginners, someone that's just looking to want to try a triathlon, get their feet wet without overcommitting and doing an outdoor race, which obviously involves a lot more equipment, all the way up to professionals apparently. We had a professional athlete in the field, shout out to Jacqueline Godby, and congratulations to her. She took first overall female and first overall. In fact, I'm honored to have taken second place behind her. Congratulations to everyone else that competed and completed the event. Now, that kind of gets me to the question of the week for all of you. I want to hear what you think of indoor triathlons, and if you use them, how do you fit them into your training? And if you don't, why not? I personally think indoor triathlons are great, especially as someone that lives in a northern climate, to keep a little bit of that race seasoning in the legs throughout the winter months. Now, let me know what your thoughts are below. All right, so let's get into the rest of the week outside of the indoor triathlon. Now, obviously last week for me was a recovery week, which meant Monday for me was a ramp test. And honestly, that was about the only thing of the week that didn't go well. On the ramp test, I didn't get any increase in FTP, still sitting at 292 watts. Honestly, was a little disappointed with the result, but I was able to bounce back quickly and had excellent workouts, hit every single interval, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. I restructured the week a little bit. If you've watched some of my prior videos, you'll also know I typically fill in a Zwift race at some point in time. This week I decided not to do the Zwift race so that I could fit the indoor triathlon in. Think that was an excellent idea so that I could keep up or get a little bit of the triathlon seasoning going here early in the year. Still to come for me is an outdoor easy run. Here Sunday in Chicago, we're looking at highs nearly 50 degrees, so you'll definitely catch me out somewhere on the lakefront. I'll share some of those videos with you in next week's video. Check out some of these videos from the week.